This might come as a surprise, but these solar panels behind me are giving this house power through a normal plug and a normal wall outlet. No complicated wiring required. The new Utah House Bill 340, signed just a few weeks ago, allows you to take up to 1,200 watts worth of solar panels, which is four of them, and plug them into a normal wall outlet to give your house or apartment free power. This is not an April Fool's joke, it is actually real, and Utah so far is the only state in the USA to allow this kind of plug-and-play system. And luckily, I live here. It's all made possible with this, an EcoFlow Stream microinverter, as well as an EcoFlow Stream Ultra battery, and today I'm going to show you how to install it. For us today to get our 1200 watts of solar, we have four panels, and we've already laid it out in the center of the roof. Lately, instead of needing to find a joist underneath the shingles, companies are moving more towards a deck mount system, where you can put these feet anywhere on the roof without needing to find a joist. We're still finding the joist anyway, using a hammer and tapping the roof till you hear something solid, just as like an extra level of, you know, getting more threads into the wood so they attach a little better. But technically speaking, you can put these anywhere. Obviously, since we just put two holes in the roof, we're gonna put some sealant around the edges of those bolts. Luckily, the feet have a little channel, so as we inject the sealant into the back, it goes between and around the holes we just made, keeping the shingles watertight. Here in Utah, the maximum distance between two of the feet is 48 inches, and so we have two at the end of the panels, and then we just stagger the rest of the feet, lining up with each of the joists underneath the roof. The panels themselves aren't very heavy, but since we have a lot of snow here in Utah, snow loads are pretty important. And since panels can usually perform above 80% capacity for more than 25 or 30 years, we want to make sure they're safe. You might be like, hey Jerry, what if I don't live in Utah and I want to try plugging solar panels into my wall outlet? And the answer is, without an electrical meter that can read power going in both directions, you'll just get billed for the energy you are producing. Your power bill would increase as if you left an electric oven on all day. Obviously, as with any electrical project, check your own local laws and regulations first. I'm just a guy on the internet. So we have the microinverter on this array, but since the battery also has inputs on the back, I'll explain more later, we're putting another three panels on this side. We're still staying under that 1200 watts, we just have an extra three panels plugging directly into the battery without touching the grid, just so the battery can stay topped up longer as the sun is setting, giving us more power into the night. We have extra panels, but we're not breaking any rules. The street name for this kind of solar setup is balcony solar, and it's been super popular in Germany for a while now, and it's nice to see the USA joining in for the first time. Now, the hardest part of this whole operation is where to put the solar panels. Yeah, you could get this foldable solar panels or set up a lawn array, but since we have roof space at this location, we might as well use it. With some of my previous solar installations, we would daisy chain the solar panels together, which works great for a grid-tied system. Technically, this is also grid-tied. But since we have the EcoFlow Stream microinverter this time around, we have whips, or leads that extend to each of the panels. The most important thing though is to hear that little click each time the MC4s, the little plugs, make the connection. If I ever need to remove the panels for whatever reason, they can all be taken down pretty quickly, probably in less than an hour. Because this whole system is going to be installed through a wall outlet, there is a limit to how much solar you can install on a single circuit. Obviously, your home wiring is an important factor in this, and if you have an older home, you definitely want to have a professional come make sure the wires are thick enough to handle the full 1200 watts. And since this bill is so new, you do have to have a smart meter that reads the electricity going in both directions, since some of this solar energy will flow back out to the grid. But I do know that Rocky Mountain Power does that for free, and has been preemptively upgrading everyone's meters for the past 4 years in anticipation of a bill like this. Another thing to keep in mind is that the Stream microinverter, or the Stream Ultra battery that you'll see in a second, does not take you off grid. They both have a feature called built-in anti-islanding, which automatically turns themselves off if it senses the grid power go down. So this particular solar setup is grid tied, but I do have a video about going off grid in a city with the EcoFlow Delta Pro Ultra, which you should definitely check out if that's your thing. The install of that system is just slightly more complicated. The Utah price per kilowatt hour is about 14 cents right now, so I'm really only saving about a dollar's worth of electricity every day, give or take. But that is $365 a year, which adds up and isn't bad at all. With no permits or crazy expensive hardware, the return on investment happens much quicker with this new law, and more importantly, energy independence is priceless. First panel we install, we want to square it up with the rails that we ran earlier. Some roofs have like fluctuations in the shingles or the plywood that's underneath, and you've seen that the feet have adjustable height adjustment, so the rails that we installed earlier are indeed level and flat. And now we can take the silver end clamps, which grab the inside edge of the panel and pull it tight as we ratchet down that bolt. Everything on the snap and rack system which we're using, I'll put a link down in the description, is a half inch, which is nice because then you only have to have one tool on the roof. The next one that we're going to install has something called a mid clamp, and the panels will just slide in underneath the mid clamp, and we'll sense them down in a second after we plug it into the microinverter. This is the only panel that does not need leads because it is sitting so close to the inverter. If the first panel is lined up pretty square, chances are the rest of the panels will be too. If it looks straight, it is straight. And of course, one of the most important rules of solar panels is that none of the wires can ever touch the roof. So we use zip ties to keep those wires attached to the rails. With all the solar panels installed, we could just plug our Stream microinverter directly into the wall at this point and be done. But EcoFlow did send us over the Stream Ultra battery, which will save us some sun juice to use at night when the sun goes away. This battery has a 10-year warranty and uses LFP type cells, which means that even after 6,000 cycles or 16 years worth of use, it will still be at 70% capacity. Battery technology has come a really long ways recently. You can also daisy chain up to 6 of these batteries together at the same time, which would give you 11.5 kilowatt hours of capacity. And this battery, just like the Stream microinverter, plugs directly into a wall outlet, which means there's no complicated circuit breaker or control panel wiring to worry about, and no electrician needed. Assuming, of course, your house is new enough to handle the load in the first place. This is the wire coming from the 1200 watts of solar on the roof going directly into a wall outlet. And if we take a look at the good old app here, jump into the microinverter, we can see that each of the solar panels are outputting, well, around 360 watts in total. It's plugged directly into the house right now, but I can take the same plug, pop it into the Stream Ultra, and the power feeds the Ultra, which then feeds the house with the battery in the middle, so that when the sun goes down, the house can still have power to use in the evening and early morning. Flip this around so we can take a look at the ports on the back. So obviously we have our solar connections down here. We have 8 ports in total, which is 4 panels. This is where we can daisy chain additional batteries together. This is the microinverter in, or they can both be used as power out with the 2 kilowatts of juice inside the battery. I think it's like 1.9. And then this right here is the port that also goes out to the wall outlet, with 2 carrying handles on the side. And then it's really cool that this light right here on the outside is always visible to see how much juice you have left in the battery. These 1200 watts are connected directly to the EcoFlow Stream microinverter, and then we have 3 panels over here, which is about 800 watts, connected directly to the battery. Panels on this side are gonna get the sun as it rises in the east, and the panels on this side are gonna get the sun as it sets in the west, giving us complete power all day long, while still being within that 1200 watt Utah limit, since the battery is what's going to be the gateway between the panels and the house. If we were not installing the battery, we only would have installed this single array. There you have it, the easiest solar installation I have ever done. I, for one, am a huge fan of Utah's new law, and I'm a huge fan of EcoFlow capitalizing on it so quickly. Hopefully someday the rest of the states can enjoy what we're enjoying right now with the EcoFlow Stream microinverter and the EcoFlow Stream Ultra. I'll leave a link for all that down in the video description, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.